article Dr. WordPress made by someone else checklist. That is, we're being called a few times in the last few weeks by people asking us to do support or hosting or further development of the WordPress site. And the agency did that, but the agency won't provide any more support. So before you should just say yes to such a contract, you might want to ask a few questions. And that's what I'm going to tell you today. So there are two situations we face this year the most. The first could be the banner situation. There's a completely new WordPress installation made by an agency or a freelancer, and they don't do hosting or they don't do support, so they need another agency to do that stuff for them. And that's cool because you obviously have the newest WordPress version, you obviously have new plugins and everything, but it can still be a major fuck-up, if you ask me. I'll have some examples later. And then there's situation number two, which we're facing currently. We have a WordPress installation with version 3.5, with plugins that don't even exist anymore. But it's 4 years old, and you might have a chance in that case to just do it completely new, but there's a small chance of your customer not paying you 10,000 francs if it's new, because it's a very extensive installation. And we've also faced number 3 and 4, the kind of mix of both. So there's a lot of things you should ask before you take over support for something you did to yourself. From a project management point of view, first, you surely have to ask the previous freelancer or agency, is there any documentation? Do you have PHP doc? Do you have specs? Do you have some kind of PDF where it's written what the website actually does? Because I'm not talking about your grandma's blog or something. I'm talking about company websites, extensive sites here. Then another very important question, especially if you're a freelancer or an agency who develops things and you don't do support like content editing, ask your customer if they do changes on their own or if they have been trained for the specific website features. Because I had a case this year where we took over, we didn't ask that, and then we switched that to our own hosting service, no problem, everything went well. And then we received mails like 4 or 5 times per week. Could you change that text? Could you change the header on that site? Could you plug in that widget there? And if you don't want to do that stuff, you should ask before you sign a contract. I didn't ask it, so now I have to do that stuff. I'm a developer and I don't like to do that stuff. And then, of course, you might want to ask them if they did test the software, but don't ask the developer if he did test the software. You might want to ask him, how did you test it? Did you unit test it? Do you have automated tests? And you will get the answer. Mm-hmm. Because I had a case where a developer was majorly offended when I asked him if he did test the software. Of course he did test the software, but it didn't work in Internet Explorer 10, so I don't think he tested it. And then there's the technical part. First thing you should ask about is hosting me. Because we have a very special case. We're currently hosting a WordPress cluster for a firm that has been closed down, and the cluster is only running till the end of the year. So we have 120 WordPress installations that we need to move away from that, from like a closed source mix up of WordPress and other stuff, social media stuff. And it's very hard to move that because there's no FTP access, all we can provide is SQL docs. And you won't believe me how many agencies still ask something about how they get their stuff out of their infrastructure to their own hosting. Zero questions were asked. I had one very funny case where we didn't hear anything about that page the whole year, and then we received a mail from an agency and they said, well, we did that site new, we're going to move it to our own servers, could you please send me a dump and an upload folder by email? And I told them, well, yes, if your email is does allow me to give you 320 gigabytes of data. They set up a server with 10 gigabytes of data, so that they weren't able to move the 320 gigabytes to their server. They had to set up everything new. They had to switch from hosting to managed server with a lot of storage. If they asked before, they would have known that. They could even have taken a look at the page because it's a video streaming service. So I don't know why people don't ask those questions. Then in some environments, you will have like test systems, deployment systems, and GitHub deployments, automated deployments, whatever. If you don't know that stuff, better keep your hands off it fast. And in one case, we had paid plugins license fees where the agency paid the licenses, and once we took it over, we had to repay the licenses. Of course, in most cases, these are only like $50 to $100 per 6 months. And it doesn't cost anything to ask it. Then, second technical part, if possible, take a good look at the code. I have seen some messy things, a lot of messy things. Even with that one installation where we had a WordPress for two in the project, that was a newly developed WordPress, but they did everything themselves. They made a child theme from 2014, but there's nothing to see of 2014. But it was still a child theme and it loaded the whole functions PHP for nothing. And then they overrided their a lot of filters, they provided only many walkers, they replaced the whole gallery shortcode, and it resulted in like 4,000 lines of code that are not maintainable in the next 3 or 4 years. So if you want to be a good developer for your new client, you might want to look at the code before you take it over and further develop it. And of course, in some cases, you can do everything that thing. And then what took me a lot of times is some PHP or front-end framework. We have seen Gulp, we have seen Compass, all those that CSS stuff. And you need like Ruby, you need Ruby virtual machines to get that stuff running just to compile the CSS. And you need to get this stuff running if you want to do changes for the customer, of course. So you might want to ask if there are frameworks in use that you don't even know. And you might want to rethink if you really want to do that job. So, of course, if possible, you should try to install it locally, if your client allows it, before you sign a contract. In some cases, it's possible, in some not. But if you're unsure if you should take over something, better ask twice. Here's a list of questions you can ask. There are a lot more questions you should pose or can pose. So it greatly depends on the size or the concept of the website you're going to take over. So this is just a reminder, so you won't forget. Well, that's about it.